Divine word of Allah. It is the final revelation to humanity. It is a means of healing, both spiritually and physically. Whosoever abides by it is guided. To ponder and reflect on its beautiful verses.
Allah la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum.
Join me on Tafsir al-Quran al-Kareem.
Appreciate the significance of tafsir to realize the essence of the Quran in Tafsir of Quran. Every Sunday, Tuesday and Thursday at 11 p.m. and repeat telecast at 12:30 p.m. UK on Peace TV.
If I were to ask you about the life of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the incidents that occurred before his prophethood and in Mecca and in Medina, about the names of his loved ones and his wives and his children, how much would we be able to know? How many incidents have we memorized? Brothers and sisters, isn't it more important that we study the seerah of the most important human being who ever walked the face of this earth? Join me, your host Yasir Qadhi, as we discuss the most important biography of the most illustrious human being that ever lived, the seerah of our beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Join Yasir Qadhi in Seerah of the Prophet, peace be upon him, every Monday at 3:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 2 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
What are the etiquettes we should follow when calling to Allah? Is the best dawah through speech or good manners? Is changing our character a process or a switch? Learn how to change for the better with me, Abdurrahim Green. Through a series of talks, Characteristics of the Caller, here on Peace TV.
Explore the unique source of guidance to call people to the path of Allah in Characteristics of the Caller. Every Wednesday at 8 p.m. and repeat telecast at 8:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV. Peace TV presents over 100 million viewers at one of the largest peace conferences in the world, addressing a sea of spellbound spectators, over 30 world-renowned orators on Islam, with credentials impeccable.
The truth of Islam.
Deen is your way of life.
It is our duty, our obligation.
By following the Quran and Sunnah,
we will give the message to one and all. One and all.
With articulation exquisite.
Read the book of Allah.
Islam is the easy way. It's the simple way.
Remind each other.
The Muslim is not a source of harm for other people.
Collaborate with the people for good.
This is the call of Islam.
With the mission of spreading the truth of Islam.
Do what you can to spread the word of Islam.
Wherever we are,
live like Muslims.
Use your power.
Allah is saying, why do you need anything else? This Quran is self-sufficient.
The only book on the face of the globe, the Quran.
How a human being should lead his life is given in this instruction manual, the glorious Quran.
For peace to prevail on earth in peacemakers. Every Sunday to Friday at 10:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 1 p.m. UK on Peace TV.
What would you recommend?
Peace TV presents.
What do you have to say about
learning the wise way?
What would you recommend us to take as career?
After we pass our school, so what exactly we should do?
What do you have to say about pursuing two fields together?
Ideas brilliant. Strategy sustained.
The best profession is a profession of a person who invites people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Avail the opportunity with Dr. Zakir.
Depending upon what is your interest. But the main aim should be to spread the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
To implement the convincing Islamic cum educational formula to excel in your career, watch Career Guidance every Friday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV. Thursdays provide.
In Britain, we are facing one big problem, that are you Muslim or British?
The space to talk.
In India, back home, they ask, are you a Muslim first or Indian first? And we Muslims should know how to reply, how to turn the tables over.
The place to knock.
Why Trinity cannot be regarded in that sense, Father, Son and Holy Spirit?
The opportunity to ask.
But even if you agree that what the Christians say, that he was crucified, so if Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, died for 3 days, who controlled the world? That means even God died?
The freedom to unmask.
So there are various ways which we can prove the argument to be wrong.
Let's meet Dr. Zakir every Thursday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV. Solution for humanity.
You were never alone.
You were never alone.
Just reach into your heart and Allah is always there. You were never alone.
You were never alone.
Through sorrow and through grief, through happiness and peace.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Time now to introduce to you Mr. Sharif Gamal. He's a human development specialist. Assalamu alaikum, Mr. Sharif.
Thank you for being here.
Mr. Sharif, allow us to start by defining stress and differentiating stress from pressure.
Okay, most of the time people mix between two things, stress and pressure. So they always say stress management. So what we're saying here, that there's pressure and there is stress. So in our life, who of us don't have pressure in his life? All of us, there is pressure in our lives in many situations. So I can handle any situation. I can handle as a human being any pressure. But the point is, when I leave this pressure, just handling it, and sometimes I carry it with me, I carry pressure more and more until it reaches a level, this level I can't handle it anymore.
Boiling point.
Yes, exactly. At this point, this is stress. This is stress. It's like the balloon. You know, when you blow up a balloon and you keep blowing it, and so it goes to a point where it will blow up. That happens also with us, with our body. When we keep carrying this and never take a break or relax or do the techniques I will talk about,
right,
we break down, our body breaks down.
Right. What are first the sources of stress, the most common sources of stress?
Okay, mainly the stress comes from how I perceive things. So if any situation happened and I perceived it as it's a stress, it will be a stress to me. Just for example, If I'm sitting here and a cup of water or anything just dropped, I can explain this and interpret this as a stress for me. So I get anger. So this would be a source of stress for me. But the main topics about stress is the financial stress, especially in the family. The financial stress, the economical level they are living in, the career for the father, for example, the career stress, his job, his manager, this is stress. So mainly any interaction with life, there is a pressure. Once we wake up in the morning, we start being in this action. We are in action. So once we find that we reach this point I told you about, the boiling point or the stress, we don't wait for this point to happen, actually. We want to live our life not just coping with the stress. We want to enjoy our life. We want to live happily. I'm not just in action. I'm stressed. No, I want to just live the life and interpret everything. Don't take the life personally.
Right. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised a man who asked him for an advice three times. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, لا تغضب, don't get angry. We want to know from you the emotional steps towards stress. I mean, where does it usually start and what's the most dangerous of them? The emotional part of it.
Yes, of course. Anger is very damaging to the body because when you're in anger, all your body is activated. You want to do something. So if you didn't do anything about it, it will just stay in, all this energy will stay in your body and it will damage your body. Maybe the liver, you know, anger damages the liver, and being in an anxiety, it damages the this part of your body. And when Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us, La taghdab, don't be angry, he gave us a solution. When you're anger, if you're standing up, so sit down, change your physical position. If you sit down and still anger, go.